here is the cement mixer. Let's just go over what we have here. Here we have a switch connected to a 3/4 horse motor by a piece of long iron. Like I said, there's a 3/4 horse motor. And I don't think you need that, but you'd probably get away with a third or a quarter. But I like this because the shafts lined up. I have a motor connected to a gear reduction unit. I attached them with an old pulley. Okay, the gear reduction unit came off like a hoist. And I ripped it apart. And this is the part that actually drove the chain. I'll turn it real quick. Now it drives our bucket. And this piece here is just a flywheel part of the furnace. This piece here is a pulley off of a furnace. And a plastic bucket, which I reinforced with sheet metal and a bunch of sheet metal screws. Now keep in mind, this is just like a prototype. When we're happy with it, we'll not mold everything together. So all the sheet metal screws will come out. You can see how we anchored our motor to the 2x12. And we'll put nuts and bolts in that once we use it and make sure this is how we're happy with what's the machine. So here's our bucket, and then inside this bucket is our mixing bucket. And let me pull this bucket out for you. Okay, I pulled that bucket out of this one. You can see inside here we have some nuts and bolts and sheet metal screws, and we reinforced the bottom to the bottom. So we made like a sandwich in there to make that plastic a lot stronger. And this is our mixing bucket. And I did make a mixer. Now, for the mixer, it works pretty good. But we might do this another way. And all I did for this bucket was cut the corners or the edges off a little bit. And when I pull this out, we'll take a look at that. And for the legs, the only part I had to buy was the flanges. So really, I'd melt this thing for almost nothing. And 2 3/4-inch lengths. And I'd sneakily stable. And once we're happy with this, you know, we get a better 2x4 and connect it a little better. And we're pretty stable. Doesn't seem to want to move. So I'm happy with that. So I'm going to put this bucket back in here and just run it and show you. Okay, we'll turn this on and I'll just show you how it runs a little bit. Now we get fairly good mixing with this contraption I made. Although to truly mix some, I think we need to make improvements. I've taken this out, and this is what it looks like. It's all sheet metal, it's manual. Two pieces on the side for making a mixer, and kind of like a piece for a scoop. But this is going to need some remeasurements, before I'm happy with that. And now you can fit any bucket in here you want. You can see on this bucket how I notched out the sides like a half inch. And our mixer actually sits in there. Okay, I'm going to turn it on and This is kind of how I think I'm going to use this to mix things up. I'm just going to put a shovel in there. I think this does a better job mixing. Of course, we're just mixing sand right now. So, I think that's how we're going to use it right now. Alright, let me break this down for you. I've taken the sensor room out. It allows you to take this off. Of course, put your sensor room back in so you don't lose it. In your pulley. Come on. And there you have it. Now, I plan on using this to carry it, but we might put a set of wheels on it sometime. I'm not sure about that yet. But there you have it. That's where we can bring it down to right now. We'll get into actually mixing up some concrete in another video and actually using it a little bit. But there it is. That's our cement mixer, our bucket mixer we made. You can mix anything in that, concrete, plaster, mortar, dirt, sand, seeds, whatever you want to mix. So, but the total cost for me was like $12. Now, I've seen them gear reduction boxes on eBay, and I'm not sure about the 3/4 horse motor. Like I said, you don't need that bang, so an old furnace motor would probably work pretty good. But that's pretty much as far as we got with our bucket mixer. And we're doing pretty good on price right now.